former President Rodrigo Duterte revealing the possible location of fugitive pastor Apollo Quiboloy. In a press conference Thursday, Duterte said Quiboloy might be hiding in the Kingdom of Jesus Christ properties in Tamayong Village in Calinan, Davao City. But Duterte warned it may be challenging for authorities to search the area given its vast size. Duterte's revelation came after he denied he is cuddling and hiding Quiboloy in his house. The former president also said he would not accept the pastor if he will surrender to him. Meanwhile, another arrest warrant has been issued against Apollo Quiboloy. The Pasig Regional Trial Court ordered Quiboloy's arrest for qualified human trafficking, which is a non-bailable case. The court also denied the motion of Quiboloy's camp to defer the proceedings. The Kingdom of Jesus Christ leader has been in hiding since a Davao court ordered his arrest on charges of sexual abuse of minors. And at the White House, where long-simmering tensions between China and its neighbors took center stage during the historic trilateral summit of the U.S., Japan, and the Philippines. U.S. President Joe Biden launched the summit by reaffirming Washington's commitment to defend the Philippines under the 1950s-era Mutual Defense Treaty. Biden is expected to announce new joint military efforts and infrastructure spending for the Philippines as he hosts President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. alongside Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida in Washington.
Today, we mark a historic moment. The first ever leaders summit between the United States, Japan, and the Philippines. And it's truly an honor to have you both here as we begin this new era of a partnership. And today, we commit to writing that story in the future together, to building the Indo-Pacific that is free, open, prosperous, and secure for all. And I want to be clear, the United States defense commitments to Japan and to the Philippines are ironclad. They're ironclad. As I've said before, any attack on Philippine aircraft, vessels, or armed forces in the South China Sea would invoke our mutual defense treaty.
We meet today as friends and partners.
President Marcos, meanwhile, thanked both the U.S. and Japan for their support in helping the Philippines counter China's growing aggression.
We meet today as friends and partners bound by a shared vision and pursuit of a peaceful, stable, and prosperous Indo-Pacific. It is a partnership born not out of convenience nor of expediency, but as a natural progression of a deepening relation and robust cooperation amongst our three countries. This is a meeting that looks ahead. As we deepen our ties and enhance our coordination, we seek to identify ways of growing our economies and making them more resilient, climate-proofing our cities and our societies, sustaining our development progress, and forging a peaceful world for the next generation.
Beijing claims almost the entire South China Sea, despite Manila's 2016 arbitral victory, which invalidated China's historical claims. Japan also has a dispute with China over islands in the East China Sea. Former President Rodrigo Duterte is setting the record straight on his alleged gentleman's agreement with China. During a press conference aired on SMNI's Facebook page, Duterte said he conceded nothing to China during his administration. But he says Manila and Beijing did agree to maintain the status quo in the West Philippine Sea, meaning no movement, no armed patrols, and no bringing of repair materials to BRP Sierra Madre to manage tensions. A Senate probe on the alleged deal has been sought, with some critics of the former president calling the agreement treasonous and unconstitutional. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. also said he was horrified by the deal. China again calling on the Philippines to honor a supposed promise and agreement in their maritime row. Beijing insists the Philippines reneged on its promise to tow away the BRP Sierra Madre from the Ayungin Shoal. It also slams the Philippine government for denying reaching an agreement with China during the Duterte administration. China continues to claim Manila is the one provoking Beijing by bringing construction materials to the BRP Sierra Madre, the lone Navy outpost of the Philippines in the West Philippine Sea.
China has been working with the Philippines to manage the situation on the Rinnai Reef through dialogue and consultation. The reasons for the current situation on the Rinnai Reef are clear and obvious. If the Philippines truly wants to ease the situation on the Rinnai Reef through dialogue and communication, it should honor its promise, abide by consensus, and stop provocations.
The U.S. Air Force insists its going aerial combat exercises with the Philippines are not meant to target any current threats. Bianca Dava has more.
The Philippine Air Force on Thursday trained side by side with the United States Pacific Air Forces as part of the first iteration of their bilateral Cope Thunder exercise this year. Members of the two air forces conducted basic fighter maneuvers at the Basa Air Base in Pampanga. The drills allowed them to show their capability and readiness to respond to possible threats in the region. In the drills conducted today, Americans flew four of their F-16 fighter aircraft, while Filipinos also used four of our F-A-50 lead-in fighter aircraft. The air operation drills were conducted over waters in the western side of Zambales.
For today, for this week, we have air-to-air exercises up until next week. It will be composed of basic fighter maneuvers to air combat maneuvers up until tactical intercept. And then after that, after which, we'll be having some limited air-to-surface.
We practice interoperability here, so we're trying to prepare our pilots in terms of the communication standards, in terms of tactics, techniques, and procedures.
Philippine Air Force spokesperson Colonel Maria Consuelo Castillo said the Cope Thunder training is part of the country's preparations for participating in international exercises, specifically the Australian-led Pitch Black Warfare exercise scheduled in July. For the first time, the PAF will send its F-A-50 lead-in trainer fighter aircraft to the drills.
We're going to have our biggest participation so far in the Pitch Black exercise, which is expected to happen in Australia by July, July to August. And previous years ng Pitch Black exercise sa Australia, normally nagpapadala lang tayo ng observers. This time, we are planning to send fighter aircraft. So, magkakaroon tayo ng large force deployment.
The U.S. Air Force stressed, Cope Thunder is not directed towards the Philippines' challenges to its territory and sovereign rights. Instead, the exercise aims to strengthen the two air forces' bilateral partnership to maintain a free and open Indo-Pacific.
And we've been doing exercises like this for many years now, and we'll continue to do so. And not because of any current things going on in the world right now, but just because both the U.S. and the Philippine Air Force believe that as we work together to make a free and open Indo-Pacific, we prepare ourselves to operate in a joint environment one day for not any current present threat, but potentially future threats that we might even not know about yet.
Aside from field exercises, the Filipino and American airmen also conducted subject matter expert exchanges on maritime strike and anti-ship tactics. The first iteration of Cope Thunder will run until April 19. A second iteration is scheduled in June. Meanwhile, the Philippine Air Force is expecting the arrival of more air assets in the next 2 years as part of Horizon 2 of the AFP modernization program.
This year, we are expecting more aircraft coming in as part of our acquisition and modernization program under the Horizon 2. So, may mga contracts na to, and for the next 1 to 2 years, we are expecting them to come in. We're expecting more Black Hawk helicopters. We are expecting C-130s.
Multi-role fighters, which have been on the PAF's wish list for quite some time now, are expected to be acquired under Horizon 3. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News, Florida Blanca, Pampanga.
More investment pledges pouring into the Philippines as the trilateral summit in Washington takes place. The White House announced Japan and the U.S. will open a string of investments across the Philippine island of Luzon to accelerate the creation of high-impact infrastructure projects there. The so-called Luzon Corridor will be part of the U.S. Partnership for Global Infrastructure and Investment, will connect Subic Bay, Clark, Manila, and Batangas. It will also include investments in transportation, clean energy, and semiconductors, among others. Philippine Ambassador to the U.S., Jose Manuel Romualdez, earlier said the country is expected to receive at least $100 billion in investments from Washington and Tokyo in the next 5 to 10 years.